Greetings, everyone. This is Michael, and welcome to day 4 in our series of reviews where Ramble Raff for Life and I are reviewing the same films, posting each film each individual day beginning this past Monday. Today is Wednesday, and we're on the next movie. Now, this is a film that was directed by George McCowan, and it's a movie that actually I have in my collection. And I probably wouldn't have watched it unless Matt had not have picked it, but I did watch it. And I have my trusty laptop here, guys. You can see the keyboard over here just a little bit. But like I said, it was directed by George McCowan. And this is a guy that didn't really direct any other feature films. He did a lot of television. I mean, some really good television. The classic shows Heart to Heart, Fantasy Island, some episodes of SWAT, and many others. So some really good TV shows he directed. This film, which I'm going to show you now, guys, Frogs. And that cover is just a little bit misleading, guys, because this frog does not swallow or eat a human arm. As a matter of fact, the frogs in the film are the size of regular frogs. And they don't even spit or bite on anybody in the film. But and you know what? Most of the frogs are not even frogs. They're toads. So we have Frogs. A shocker reminiscent of Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds. Variety. Variety said that? Well, I used to think Variety was a reputable newspaper. They must have had some really schlocky people working for them back in 1972. The film came out in 1972, guys, and believe it or not, it actually starred Ray Millard and Sam Elliott. Now, Ray Millard, many of you probably won't know, he done a lot of television. And the only role that I really remember him in is he played in the first movie of the 1970s Battlestar Galactica. He played one of the 12 members. He played one of the members of the council, the 12 members of the council. And I think his name was Sire Yuri. But pretty decent in that one. And then we have Sam Elliott, who the last role I've seen him in, and that was in 2007 in Ghost Rider, where he played Carter Slade. But he's real young in this film, and it's kind of interesting to see him. And also in this film, guys, we have Joan Van Ark, who did quite a bit of 70s television. Her most notable role is probably the television show Knots Landing. It was a primetime soap opera. And I remember her from that role, which actually began on the classic primetime soap Dallas and then kind of inspired Knots Landing. Other actors, let's see. None that I know by name. Frogs, guys, is a story of, well, figure it out, frogs. And not only frogs, guys, frogs, snakes, lizards, birds, all these creatures have been subjected to pesticides by the owner, Ray Millard, who owns this house. I believe it's in Florida. He owns this house that's kind of separated from every other place. You can only get there by boat. I think it's Florida. It might not be Florida. But you can only get there by boat, and so he's secluded. He's wheelchair-bound. He can't move around for himself. Well, I mean, he can move in the wheelchair, but he can't get up without assistance and all this. He has two helpers, and they're black. No, but he has two helpers, the day of the white maid and butler. No, but anyway, guys, I'm just acting silly. Just ignore me. But he has two servants, and apparently every time his birthday rolls around, which happens to be the 4th of July, he has this big shindig where he invites all his family down and all this stuff. Well, this year, because of his continued pesticides, killing frogs and all these other animals, and you know, this is just one person, so he's not really using that many pesticides or killing that many animals, but the animals all get together and they have a meeting at Hooters. Okay, I'm exaggerating. They all get together, the frogs, the snakes, the lizards, the birds, and they plan this attack or annihilation of everybody on the island, and they start attacking. And this is just a basic nature against man movie, but unfortunately, all the scenes we see with frogs and snakes and lizards, they're not really in the scenes with the people. Every now and then you might see a couple, but there's no actual attacks. You don't see anything being attacked. You just see the animals, this ominous music, these screams. And usually the attacks involve people just backing up or running away from the frogs or snakes or lizards, and they fall in the quicksand, or they hit their head, get wrapped up in vines in a tree or something like that. It's never actually shown that a snake actually bites one of these people and poisons them. So you never see anything like that in the film. And Sam Elliott plays an environmentalist, a photographer, who gets trapped on the island. And he decides, my phone's ringing again. He decides to kind of stay on the island and help the people out. But he keeps telling everybody about the severity of the problem. And this is a... the rest of the movie is just countless death scenes with animals in the scenes, but not actually participating in the deaths. And if I quote my girlfriend, she said, "The animals are not even killing anybody. The people are just killing themselves. They're panicking and running and jumping." And so you don't see any actual animal attacks. Now, this is pre-CGI. If CGI had been around at the time, I'm sure we would have seen the attacks. But these were like just, you know, 500 frogs they purchased and just put them in the scenes, and nobody's really getting hurt, so there's really no suspense, no drama, no gore. There's really not much of anything. This was just a, be honest, I love B films, but this is just a terrible B film. It's pretty slow, pretty boring, and it's just, you know, I had to struggle to get through it, guys. I can't even recommend this movie. This is a terrible film. So far in our series of reviews, this is the worst film that I've seen. And I'm going to hold that against Matt for the rest of my YouTube life. Have me watch this damn thing. But yeah, this was terrible, terrible, terrible. And definitely a waste of the talented actors involved. I can't believe that somebody sent them a script that said frogs, and they go, "Wow, I'm going to jump on that." But it's just a movie that I can't recommend, guys. You know, I always usually say watch it one time, but this is just a complete, utter waste of time. It's just no. No, don't see it, no. Let's see if there's anything else I need to tell you guys about this film. No? They got a 21% on Rotten Tomatoes, and to me, that's pretty damn high for this film. But definitely, guys, Frogs is definitely one that's not worth your time. So don't check it out. But what can we do? Thanks for watching, everybody. Take care. And you know, I hate saying don't watch a film. I mean, give it a shot. But most likely, you're not going to like Frogs. There's nothing that jumps out in this movie at all. Take it easy, everybody. Wow. Andy Warhol played a frog in this. Didn't know that.